बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम नहमदुहू व नसल्ली अला रसूलिहिल करीम। द पर्पस ऑफ दिस सेशन इज़ टू डिस्कस सम एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लानिंग एज प्रैक्टिस्ड बाय प्रोफेसर सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम। स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लानिंग इज रिलेटेड विद विजन एंड मिशन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। Vision, as you can see from this definition, is the long-term objective of an organization. What the organization wanted to achieve in the long term. And if you took the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the Sahabi, Khabbab radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he came and accepted Islam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him that there will be a time in the future when you people, I mean the Muslims, will be appointed, will be the leaders of the world. And this was said when there were very few Muslims in Makkah, and they were going under persecution by Quraysh and other people. At another occasion, Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anh accepted Islam. He belonged to a tribe which was living away from Makkah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him that go back and they come when we'll get the upper hand. So the objective was the dominance of Islam, and this vision was the vision in the beginning of Islam. And second is mission, that how vision will be realized, what will be the method to achieve that big objective. So here you can see that there are different aspects related with the mission. It has been defined as an organization's core purpose and focus that normally remains unchanged over time. It serves as filters to separate what is important from what is not. And it states that it will be served and how that will be served. And it communicates the sense of direction of the organization. In other words, mission is an extension of the vision. Vision is the ultimate objective, and mission is the tool, instrument by which organizations achieve their objectives. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam announced his mission in the beginning of the work of Dawah. He said to the nearest effect, "O people, I have been sent to warn you about a serious reprimand. About a serious reminder." And at another occasion he said, "O people, say Allah is one. He is the only deity of worship, and you will be successful." And this was the instrument through which the mission was to be achieved. Now, Let's come to the notion of planning. This definition has been given by one of the organizations called P, and is saying that it is a complex form of symbolic actions that consists of consciously preconceiving a sequence of actions that will be sufficient for achieving a goal. It is set apart from an undeliberated action which is not preconceived. So this is something which we have to achieve in the future, and it involves many steps, because we have said about vision, the long-term objective, mission, the tool through which vision would be achieved, and in the next step are more details that how the instrument will be used in more detail. Another definition is saying planning is preparing a sequence of action steps to achieve some specific goal. So here the steps are involved which have been envisioned in the mission statement. And here there are certain questions which are related with planning, and the managers or the planners need to identify their answers. What to do, when to do, where to do, how to do, and who will to do. This is art related with the concept of planning. Now we have applied a model put forward by very famous management scientists Coons and Weirich in their famous book Management. It has another version, Essentials of Management, etc. And we have applied this model upon the Hijra expedition to know that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had applied this model centuries ago, although this model was put in action only in last century. So let's see the, what this model is and how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had applied it. So we have identified the 8 steps related with this model, and then we have linked these 8 steps with the Hijra expedition. Let's see what those 8 steps are. The first one is awareness of opportunities. The planning is made for some opportunities to achieve. And this means that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was searching the opportunity to expand the work of Dawah, to expand his product, to sell his idea. And he has identified the people in Taif and Abyssinia. Taif was nearby town, and Abyssinia was a Christian country away from Mecca. And he has also identified people of Medina. And then after identification of these 3 opportunities, he sent 2 expeditions to Abyssinia to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He traveled himself to Taif, the nearby town, because over there was a very strong a tribe strong in number. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam traveled to them to invite them towards Islam, to present the idea of Islam to them. We know that although they have not accepted the message immediately, but later on, after the conquest of Makkah, they became Muslims. And then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam identified the people of Medina, and they were the one who accepted Islam, and this was the basis of migration of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the Muslims of Makkah. Second step, setting objectives. So what will be the objectives to achieve? Here Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam set the objective to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First and foremost objective. Because pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, implementation of the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was his primary objective. To leave Makkah peacefully, without any quarrel or military encounter, and to reach Medina safely. Fourth, to establish an Islamic state in Medina. And the fifth, to propagate the idea of Islam all over the world. Third one, planning premises or assumptions upon which the planning has been done. Here, the first assumption was that the environment in Makkah was very hostile against Muslim. And the lives of the companions, even the life of Prophet ﷺ, was at risk. Second, the competition was very high, and the message of Islam was not spreading at the rate which Prophet ﷺ wanted to do. Third one is to avoid any military encounter with the enemy. So these were three assumptions before starting the journey of Hijrah. Fourth one, determining the alternatives. So for Hijrah, there were two alternatives. The first one was to leave Makkah and to travel towards Medina on the known path, straight away, without waiting. Second, to stay in a nearby place until a possible search died out, and then use a new path to reach Medina. Fifth one, that comparing these alternatives, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam identified two alternatives. The first one was not secure because enemy knew the path of Makkah to Medina, and they were after Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his team to capture them, to kill them, to harm them. And for this, they have announced a price of 100 camels. So this was a risky path, risky option. And the second was the one which Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had adapted, that they should stay in the cave for a few days until they believe that the idea of capturing the Prophet and his companion dies out, and then they should choose a unique path, unique way to travel towards Medina. This was the comparison. And then Prophet ﷺ has chosen the one which was beneficial to him. This is the selection of or choice of the better alternative. The alternative which he had adopted, and it was a successful adoption, successful choice. Seventh one, formulation of sporting plans. That the grand plan is to travel towards Medina, but there are other small plans which are supporting the grand one, has to be articulated. Prophet ﷺ had drawn three sporting plans. The first one was gathering and delivering information about the activities of enemy. So he was staying in the cave with Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه, but he wanted to know what the enemy is doing in Makkah. And for this, he has appointed an information officer who was staying in Makkah during day, and at the evening he used to go to the Prophet ﷺ and used to tell him the story which had happened in Makkah at that day. Second plan was about supply of food. So there are many ideas about it, but one idea was that the daughter of Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه was supplying the food. Third one, that since it was possible that the Prophet and his team could have been identified through the marks of the foot. For this purpose, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked one person to who was looking after the sheep and other animals, and he was also an employee of someone. So Prophet ﷺ appointed him to travel over the marks of Prophet ﷺ and his companion, or other people who were traveling towards the cave on daily basis, so that the herd of sheep would run over the marks of the foot, footprints were removed, and it was out of the enemy to identify that the team is staying in the cave. The eighth step was about the quantification of expenses of the plan. What expenses are involved by implementing a particular plan? Prophet ﷺ bought a she camel on credit for few hundred dinars or dirhams to travel from Makkah to Medina. And other services like information officer was doing volunteer job, food was supplied without any additional cost, etc. However, one of the Bedouin who was guiding the team of the Prophet ﷺ, he was paid some money. So in terms of the expenses, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam bought only one she camel for traveling, and some money was paid to the guide. So eight steps Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had completed. and he has achieved his objective. The key message for all of us is that he had planned for this journey, implemented it with all the sporting plans, and he reached Medina safely. And he left even Makkah peacefully. And these were the objectives he has defined for this planning venture. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding and ability to convey this message and to practice the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I have taken this presentation from my book, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a planning expert. I leave you with these words. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.